right, lesson number two, moving right along. Lesson number two is on linear measure and angle measures. So we're going to start with the definition called between. So what does between mean? Or betweenness of points. What do we mean when we say something is between something else? So it says in the figure on the right, point C is between points A and D, but points B and E are not. So point C is the only one that's between points A and D. So what do you notice about point C in comparison to point E? Because point E looks like it's in between, but in geometry, it's considered not to be in between. So therefore, what's the key? Well, the key is that the points need to be, number one, collinear, right? These three points are on the same line. The reason B is collinear with A and D, but it's not between them because it's on the outside, right? So it has to be in between the two and on the same line. So it says point C is between points A and D if and only if A, C, and D are collinear and with something we call the segment addition postulate. And if AC plus CD equals AD. So if we put numbers to that, let's say the distance between or the length of AC is 3 units and the length of CD is 5 units. Well, what does the length from A to D have to be? Well, it has to be 8 units. So there we go. If we know the length from A to D is 8 units and we say, you know, the distance from A to E is 3 units, but this is 6 units, well, that's no longer adding up to 8, therefore E is not in between A and D, right? So two things. One, they have to be collinear, and two, the segment addition postulate, remember that's just a rule, has to be true. So let's look at example number one and apply the betweenness definition or the segment addition postulate definition. It says, find the measure of PQ if Q is between P and R. QR equals 8 centimeters and PR equals 17 centimeters. Now notice there's no segment symbol above these right here. Whenever we're using the equal sign, if there's no segment symbol, that means we're talking about the length of. So we're talking about the length of. If we put a segment symbol on top, if we say QR, we're specifically talking about the segment itself. If we were to cut it out, the actual physical beam. If we have no symbol on top, we're talking about the length. Okay, so let's draw this picture. We have a segment. It says Q is between P and R. So we have P on one end and R on the other end, and Q is somewhere in between. Now, does Q have to be right smack in the middle? No, that's not what between means. Q could be anywhere on this segment or on this line in between P and R. So we don't really know where it is. I'm just kind of putting it there for now. So QR is 8 centimeters, so between Q and R is 8 centimeters. PR is 17 centimeters, so between P and R is 17 centimeters. So how do we find the length of PQ? Right, that's what we want to do, find the measure of PQ. Well, hopefully that's very mathematically, that's pretty simple. We're going to take 17. What are we going to do with 17 and 8? We're going to subtract the 8. And so the length of PQ is, hopefully got 9. So the length of PQ is equal to, okay, now we're going to do something a little bit trickier, only because it's algebra, so it's not so straightforward. So it says, find the value of x and the measure of PQ if Q is between P and R. So once again, if you're visual, I would strongly encourage you to draw the picture. Put Q in between there somewhere, so we have P, Q, and R. PQ is congruent to QR. So this symbol right here, remember you learned it means congruence. And when we mark congruence on a diagram, we have to we can put this little hash mark, and that tells us that this length here, PQ, is the exact same as length QR. Or congruence means if I were to cut out this segment and lay it on top of this segment, they would match completely. So QR is equal to 2x minus 1, the whole whole entire PR is equal to 3x plus 3. Well, if these two segments are congruent and this is equal to 2x minus 1, then what can we say PQ is equal to? Well, algebraically, hopefully you're saying it's the same expression, 2x minus 1. So if I double this length right here, it should equal the entire length of PR. So if I double 2x minus 1, or if I were to add that to each itself, right, twice, then I can either say 2x minus 1 plus 2x minus 1, or I can just double it here. So do the algebra, we're going to get 4x minus 2 equals 3x plus 3. My pen is terrible. You subtract 3x over here. Subtract 3x from 4x. We add 2 to move it to the other side. So what do we end up with? We end up x equals 5. So it says find the value of x. So the value of x is 5. Okay, now we have a whole bunch of definitions. Okay, so definitions related to angles. So first definition, a ray is part of a line. So it has only one endpoint and it extends indefinitely in one direction. Rays are named by stating the endpoint first and then the other point on the ray. So if you look at this diagram over here, we have several different rays. You could say one ray is x, z. So we would name that and it would be the ray starting at x and going in the direction of z. You could say we have a ray y, x, so it would start at y, going toward x, so the notation would look like this right here, endpoint and the direction it's going. You also could say we have the ray y, z, so starting at y, going toward z, so starts at y, always the endpoint is listed first, and then the direction or the point that it's going toward. You could also say we have z, y. We start at z and go toward y, so that's another ray. Now, what are opposite rays? Well, there's only one pair of opposite rays in this diagram. It says if you choose a point on a line, that point determines two rays called opposite rays. So the opposite rays in this example right here says the rays share a common endpoint, are collinear, and extend in opposite directions. The only pair of opposite rays we could have would be from y to x, right? So that's one ray, and then from y to z. So they're going in opposite directions of one another. They are collinear, and they go on infinitely, and they share a common endpoint. So those are my only pair of opposite rays in that diagram. Then you have an angle, so this definition, an angle is formed by two non-collinear rays that share the same endpoint. So right here, this is an angle, two non-collinear rays, but they share the same endpoint, F in this case. The two rays are called the sides, so FE is a side, ray FG is a side of the angle, and their common endpoint right here is called the vertex. Okay, so it says the angle on the right can be named as the following. We can name it angle EFG. We can name the angle GFE. If we put a 1 or any kind of number here where the vertex, near the vertex, we can call it angle 1. Or if it's just only one angle with that letter, we could call it angle F. So these are four different ways to name this particular angle over here. Now notice when we use the three letters, the vertex is always the middle letter. Okay, so it's EFG or GFE. And this is the angle symbol that you need to use in order to identify an angle. Okay, so we have all kinds of angles that you've probably already heard about in the past. We have 90-degree angles, which are also called right angles. 90-degree angles have a symbol kind of looking like a square in the corner to identify that it's a 90-degree angle. We have acute angles, which are less than 90 degrees. We have obtuse angles, which are more than 90 degrees, but less than 180. So it's a measurement in between 90 and 180. We have a straight angle. Everyone always forgets this. A straight angle is just 180 degrees. So that is a straight angle, angle FAB. Congruent angles have equal measures. They are the exact same size. Bisectors of angles split angles into two congruent angles, right? If we have an angle and it has been bisected, then the bisector splits that angle right in half, and these two pieces are congruent. We put a little arc symbol in there to identify that they are congruent to each other. The bisector creates the angle addition postulate, right? This angle right here, if I call this angle 1 and this angle 2, then I put letters out there on the sides. We can say, you know, if we look, let's see. The angle addition postulate, we'll use a diagram up above. If we have the measure of angle BAC and the measure of angle CAD, then that's going to equal the measure of angle BAD right here. So that's the angle addition postulate when you add those two measures up and they add up to the big angle. So this angle here plus this angle here add up to the entire large angle. Okay, let's do some algebra here. So given this diagram on the right, it says given that we have line AB and we have ray BE bisecting angle DBC. So to remind yourself that that's bisecting, put the little marks in here to tell you that those two are the same. So if the measure of EBC is 2x degrees, and the measure of ABD is 5x plus 9 degrees, and we need to find the measure of ABD. Well, we just have these two symbols right here saying that these two angles are congruent or equal in measure. So if this is 2x and this is 2x. Now, most people get stumped and they stare at this and they don't know what to do. Well, ABC is making a straight line, and a straight line creates a straight what? A straight angle. And a straight angle is equal to 180 degrees. So you're going to take 5x plus 9 plus 2x plus 2x and set it equal to 180 degrees and solve. Pause now and try that on your own. Pause now. Okay, did you get 104 degrees? Whoops, had my eraser on. 104 degrees for the measure of angle ABD? And you are correct. If not, pause and look through the math. Pause and look through the math if you're not sure. Okay, last one says in the diagram, ABD is equal to 39 degrees. That's this angle right here. The measure of CBD is equal to 3x minus 6 degrees. The measure of angle ABC is equal to 5x plus 5 degrees. See if you can pause and set it up on your own to figure out what to do. So pause, set it up, and solve, and then see if you got it right. All right, did you set it up like this using the angle addition postulate? Or in Singapore, since they use three letters, we use AAP, angle addition postulate. So you take the small angle ABD plus the other angle adjacent to it, right next to it, CBD. These two added up equal the whole entire angle ABC. So 39 degrees plus 3x minus 6 degrees equals 5x plus 5 degrees. You do your algebra, you should have gotten x equal to 14. Then you want to find, it says calculate the measure of angle CBD. So CBD is this one, so we have to substitute in 14. So 3 times 14 minus 6, that's 42 minus 6 to get 36 degrees. So you should have got 36 degrees. If you did, great. If not, and you can't pause and figure it out through this algebra right here, then you need to go see one of the geometry teachers and ask some questions. All right, get started on your assignment. Later.